Okay, I tried to be a nice guy. I offered you food, you threw it back in my face. You know what? How about I peck your eyes out and tie a cinder block to your ankle and throw you off the Brooklyn Bridge? Okay, sorry, that was my New York side talkie, but anyway, hey, and what is happening, guys? And child abuse. Oh, what did you do that for, mister? I'm off to find my mom and she'll tell my dad. Yes, the problem to that, solving that problem is child abuse. Thanks to find a little scam for me, there's still enough. But yeah, I said that a little weirdly, but anyway, yes, the answer to that problem was child abuse. Yeah, no wonder I didn't figure out in the last part that that was the solving factor. I mean, here I thought that you had to buy out your kids, and you know what? Just smack them in the face, just do it a little smack, like it, like that. Ow, my leg, okay, but anyway. Oh god, this part is starting off a little wonky, isn't it? But anyway, let's head back to the Inferno area, and, let's head out into the two different areas. I looked at our totals, and we're actually, like, really, really close to being done with this world. I think I only need one more Jiggy. That's one, two more, okay. But I think I can't get one of them. I think I can get another. Oh yeah, the boss, okay. We're missing two Jinjos. One's on the Dodgem Dome, and the other is, in the where we're going, okay. We're missing a Cheeto page. I'll have to look that up. I don't know that off the top of my head, so we're in good standing. We're in good standing. We're all doing fine. All right, so we can go in the purple one or the green one. You know what? Let's go in the purple one first. When they say go right, I always go left. Two rights make a left, okay. All right, so we are in the Haunted Cavern. Okay, it's a little dark area. They're really obsessed with these, like, dark kind of things, aren't they, in these last two worlds. But yeah, I kid you not, in the guidebook, the title to this section is called You Can't Handle the Tooth, because if you knock into one of these things, they hurt you, because these are teeth. Oh yeah, the Cheeto page, I believe, is in here, if I'm not mistaken. Is it? Let's see. Oh, don't tell me it's just eggs. I was promised a Cheeto page. What the hell? My book was wrong? Oh. Okay. Gotta watch out for that. Okay, so they only give you eggs? Well, okay, I guess I understand why they give you eggs there, because we'll be needing grenade eggs. Now let's read this. What is it? Warning! The management accepts no responsibility for soiled underwear as a result of viewing the Cave of Horrors exhibit. Ah, oh, Cave of Horrors. I wonder if it's like the Cave of Wonders. Oh, I'm in for a treat right here. Oh man, what's the... Whoa, this is really depressing. Well, you know what? We got a Jinjo. Looks like a dinosaur. And... Is that a camel with a beard? Perhaps an old friend? Alright, let's save the Jinjo first. Excuse me? Thank you. Okay, I had to aim it precisely at the lock. Alright, we saved the red one. Let's go for the dinosaur right now. Because I believe that camel has enough water to sustain him, knowing him. Thanks, but I'm not going anywhere until the chuffing train is in Witchyworld Station. Ah, a train, okay. Aw, poor little... not Tyrannosaurus Rex, you fool. I think it's a, I don't know, Velociraptor? No, it's a freaking raptor! Great, I'm on my way to the Wobble World again! Hook! Give him, like, a goofy voice. But yeah, that's Gobi! Oh my god, long time no see, he's even grown a beard! Hey, where's that bell around his, like, neck? Does he belong to someone? Does he have an owner? But man, okay, that was weird. Let's see, he's even got a question mark inside. Is your fortune a secret? Find out our Madam Grunties. Okay, I already did that. So yeah, we saved those two. I think I should have went in the green door now that I'm looking back at this. Because we have to come back here when there's a train station, obviously. Like, the little... What dinosaur is that? I will figure out what dinosaur that is by the end. Don't even comment that. I will figure it out. It's in my head somewhere. I will get it. Alright, but yeah, okay. I'm not gonna think about it now, but anyway, we're gonna head back to the green door right now because, wow, these teeth are actually, chewing me up a bit right here. We're gonna head to the green door because I believe that's where the train station is, and that little dinosaur needs our help, and, we'll only leave once the station's there. Alright, so blow yourself and blow yourself. I'll do what I did for the little boy. I'll peck your eyes out. Okay, easy there. Easy there, inner Brooklyn Yankee. I'm not even from Brooklyn. Oh, God. Hey, can't you read, Furbag? All food must be consumed in the theme park. That's not fair. Of course it's not fair, but try and leave with that stuff you've got, and I'll take it for off you. Yeah, I think she roughs you up a bit if you leave trying to... Whoa, what the... Fatty McJones? What the hell? Thank goodness you came. I'm really hungry. Don't you think you've had enough?
I'll tell you when I had enough.
No way. I just need a burger before I go to my mom. Ooh, you've got some burgers. Please, 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 can I have one? Oh, should we fuel his unhealthy eating habits? Yes, we can. All right, let's give him the burger that we probably stepped on, or the rhino did. Yummy! Are you okay, kid? You're looking a little full, shall we say. Burp, my tummy hurts. Please carry me back to Mom. I can't stand up. I'm not surprised. Okay, basically, that's the reason we can't get the Jiggy in this world by getting all of our kids, because we have to carry that little scoundrel back to his mom, and we do not know that move yet. Banjo knows that move specifically. Can I grab onto something? Yes, I can.
I have to start from right to left, perhaps. There we go, because that's the train switch. As we'll be seeing in most of the world, they have train switches. They don't just activate, so... Because we have to... Okay, I can get up there. So we have to get the gates open. Get the trains going, because the gates, once they're open, can go between the worlds. And there we go, it is from right to left, and... You're dead. And I think we'll just go up there, and, oh, wait, whoa, oh my god. Okay, there's three of them. Okay, we're back, and zoom out right there. There we go, we can get it that time. We got some much-needed health, and there we go. So, yeah, I would recommend zooming out when you face those kind of guys, because you never know. They might go from the top, they might go from the bottom. They are vile creatures, and there we go. We hit the train switch, and the gates should now open. Awesome. You can now take the train between worlds. I think it's still in Glitter Gulch Mine, so let's bring it to Witchyworld. Let's get this train up and running. Alright, let's interact. Chuffy is loading ore in Glitter Gulch Mine. Would you like Chuffy to pick you up? Yes. Basically, if you hit yes to pick us, for him to pick us up, we'll automatically go in the train, so just know that she's going to the station. And there we go, Chuffy is up and running. Yeah, I guess that boss fight with him really got him motivated. Well, we definitely motivated him, that's for sure. We got his laugh more meeting. Gave him a purpose. That is his purpose in this game, is to take us throughout each world. Because, you see right there, a little stagecoach in the back. It looks like something could fit inside of it. Perhaps that dinosaur we rescued. Still worked on the name. I should know, because I was a big fan of the Power Rangers. Oh, I think I heard the train arrive. Time to leave. Well, it's actually good I did the purple door first then. Okay. Now, wow, you're really fast for a dinosaur. There we go. You go inside the little back little passage, and we even talk to you, or are you good to go? I don't know. I think you'll stay in there for the time being. Okay. Alright, there we go. Wow, this place is much bigger than it appears. One way ticket to Pterodactyl Land, please. Pterodactyl Land? What area is that? Find the train tunnel door switches in other worlds to enable Chuffy travel between stations. Yes, we'll definitely look out for that. So, we really can't do anything right now with that dinosaur because it's saying something about Pterodactyl World. I think it's that one. And that world we're not going to be seeing for another two. I believe next world is something else, and then it'll be Pterodactyl World. Why do you saying I never, ever, ever said Pterodactyl World ever, and I don't know why I'm saying it now. It's Pterodactyl World. There we go. I got that down pat. So yeah, I think we're done with everything in this world. We're still missing that Jinjo and that Cheeto page. We can pick them up as we leave. But for now, the main attraction in the big top, let's take on the boss of the area. And we got the four tickets. Let me see your tickets, buddy. Tickets? What do we need them for? Four tickets are required to enter Kunga's Big Top. No tickets, no entry. But we have four tickets. Pass them over then, pal. Cheers. I'd better let you in now then. You're just in time. The show's about to begin. I hope they've got acrobats and a human cannonball. Oh, there are humans in this universe. I love how that's Kunga from the first game in Mumbo's Mountain. What the hell, man? He really moved up. Where do you think our seats are? I can't see any seats. Perhaps we're supposed to sit on this big lump on the floor over here. Well, it does look pretty comfy. It's kind of like the bounce house. It doesn't look very comfy. Oh, come on, Banjo. It totally does. Look at it. It looks like a little inflatable little... Oh, my God! It's hideous. Kill it. Kill it, please. Kill it with... Not fire. Grenades. There it is. Oh, dear! No more intruders! Well, I'll show you who's boss. See how big and strong Mr. Patch is. Pa, you're not all that big, really. That Klunko freak near the star was probably bigger than you. Oh, yeah? Well, how about this, then? Oop. Oh, God, Mr. Patch, strange wobbly inflatable thing. he's gonna give that wacky inflatable arm-flailing guy a run for his money. I suppose you think you're clever, don't you? Well, one doesn't like to blow one's shown trumpet. Oh, I sense a bell coming on. If you insist. Alright, so this is Mr. Patch, the Witchy World boss. Basically, we have to go to a fly pad and knock out his patches with frag grenades. Yeah, grenades, not frag grenades. Well, I guess they are frag grenades. And where are the fly pads at? I guess we'll have to just do some ground combat for now. And there we go, we got one of them down. So you found a weak spot. It looks like I might need some help here. You'll have to beat me in the air from now. Oh god, boxing gloves with anthills, our biggest enemy. There we go, now we have the flight pad. And if you don't know the airborne attack move, then you have to actually learn it before coming here, because that's how we're gonna beat him. And now he's got 11 more patches for us to, oh god, I just missed that, thank goodness. And yeah, he fires beach balls at us for some reason. Just go with it, and you gotta be very accurate. I said be very accurate, that's anything but. But yeah, there's 10 more to go, so we have to knock out each of his patches, and he'll deflate more and more. This is actually getting pretty hard. I remember this being a pretty hard jiggy to get, because this boss, it's not that the boss is hard, it's just the controls give you trouble half the time. And you're going to run out of grenades pretty fast if you're only allowed to carry 25, I believe, so. Yep, that's why they give you a lot of them. And let's actually get him in the face. Wow, this is actually harder than I thought. You would think the controls would be better on the 360 version, but it's still very hard to, like, do precise combat in this kind of thing. I don't know. Let me get some space between us. So we can get a little start. That's a little better, but still, this is really hard. I didn't really realize how hard this would be. Alright, so it's running out of eggs here. Grenades. Oh, come on, that was close. Come on! That was close, too! I'm getting robbed here. What the hell, man? You have to be, like, right on. This is ridiculous. I have to get more grenade eggs. Oh, man, I didn't think this boss would be this much of a pain in the ass. What the hell, man? It used to be so much simpler in my head, but I don't know. I guess my memory's fading. You gotta be very precise with those grenades. Huh. Luckily, they just don't transform on you into something else. All right, so we got 20 more. All right. These two are right in front of us. All right, good. At least we got one of them. 8 more to go. Okay. That was its face. Okay, good. There's another. Ooh, that was close. Okay, we gotta have that. Yeah, you would think I would just go in the ground and just shoot him that way, because that was so simple before when I just got that one right off the bat. But that's why the boxing gloves are down there. They are a fruitful reminder that, or a punching reminder that I can't do that. Because then I would probably die within a few minutes, not a second. So, oh god, okay, we're getting up close and personal. Oh god, he tried to eat me? Oh my god, that face. Only a mother can love that face. Oh man, so we just gotta create some distance between us, and I think that we should have it, but... Oh god, we gotta avoid those beach balls as well, ugh. Man, we gotta be as far away from it as possible so they don't make contact with us, because I think they have, like, direct line of fire based on, like, your trajectory in the air. That's obviously not the right saying of that, but okay. Alright, so we wanna try to go down here, yes, okay, we got that one. Going from a top to down, that was a nice little strat by me. Yeah, that's Mr. Patch Strats right there. You write a book on that. Okay, we have a nice... Oh, God! Okay, am I zoomed in too much? I might be zoomed in too much. Oh, God. Okay, right. I passed him out right. Okay. I was trying to zoom in a little. Let me try to zoom in a little on that. Okay. All right. Oh, God. I'm gonna take the hit! I could have just destroyed that with... Oh, God! It took away 2 health? What the hell, man? The first one took away 1. That's not fair. But yeah, I was trying to zoom in a little, because that might make my accuracy issue a thing in the past, but I gotta worry about those dang beach balls. Okay, let's try to zoom in again. He has one on, I think he has 2 in the front and then 1 on his tail, so we definitely wanted to make sure he goes about face. So let's go on to the other side. Hopefully he'll get a nice direct shot. Okay, we gotta avoid these beach balls. Oh god. Oh god, get down. Dive! Oh god, no, 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 no. We only have 1 health left. Oh man, this sucks. This is coming down the wire. Oh boy, I don't want to die. I don't want to die. We have to get more health too. We need more grenades and more health. I think there's like a few empty honeycombs just lying around here. Not empty. That would be very useful, but not really, because it wouldn't activate my health bar gauge. Because I have to go to honey, but you know what I'm saying. I want health. Me want honeycomb. Okay, there we go. Balance part of this breakfast. Okay. So walk up 1, 2, and we have to get off the ground because those boxing gloves are going to get us. Okay, good. We have a nice little straightaway. Let's go. We got 20 eggs. Just fire. Fire everything. Go. Come on. Yes, he's a stationary too. Nice. We got 2 of them. Okay. Just got to get behind him now. Let's get a nice little beak bomb behind him. There we go. Wish you could actually go faster in the air without having to do that, but I guess that's why that moves there. Okay, just fire straight. No, he's turned around. Oh, God. Oh, God, no. Come on, no. Ooh, oh, God, this is it. One health against one health. Oh, my God, please. I can't go down like this. I've got fans to appease. I can't lose. I can't edit this part out. Okay, in post. There we go. Yes, I won. Oh, praise the gods. Praise the inflatable gods. Oh, it looks like trouble. Yeah, take that, you stupid piece of garbage that every kid probably has once in their lifetime, but quickly gets discarded once they grow in age. Yes. I don't think it was that thing exactly, but you know what I am saying. All right, let's go fly down gracefully, get our Jiggy. Let's get the heck out of here. All right, let's get the Jiggy. Now we have to get some health fast, because we're running on freaking E right now, and that's not honeycomb slang right there. Alright, so let's leave the big top, and alright. Okay, I think that we're pretty much done with this world. All we have to do is go to the Dodgem Dome and collect that Jinjo, and we're scot-free. We basically did everything in Witchyworld. I think I took at least an hour in this place, man. I spent a lot of time in this world. I believe my practice file is like 1:10 or so, but probably with me pausing a lot, it's probably gonna be like 1:20, so. Oh well, it's long worth the wait, I guess, but we need some health right now. I'm really getting a little paranoid, so. Let's just be- Oh, come on! Picking that guy in the face didn't really give me health the time I needed it. Ugh. Aw, oh, man. So I think I need to actually be on top by the Sorcerer Peril, how I got over there. So that's why I'm taking the little monorail over there. I could've just went to the Space Zone by warping, but I think that we have to access it by grip-grabbing from the left side this time. Is there a thing we have to grip-grab onto? Okay. I thought there was for some reason. Oh, okay. We have to grab onto the pole in front of the Dodger Dome. I always overcomplicate things. Alright, let's fall down gracefully. Get this health. Okay, I feel comfortable too. I can feel that. That is decent enough. Okay, let's get up here. And, okay, we need to do a talent try. Okay, I thought we just had to just climb up there normally, but no. Let's get past the electrical mishap. And let's climb up here. And what color Jinjo? It's a blue one. Okay, I was hoping it would be an orange one because I only need one more orange Jinjo to get that Jiggy, so the switch continues, I guess. But, yeah, I think we're done with this world. I think we're gonna head back to the entrance and, call it a part. So, yeah, that's Witchy World. It's one of my favorite worlds, and, you're a terrible mother, you know that? I beat your son, and that's how he came back to you. That's how much he hates you. And basically, Garty's gonna say we can't bring food outside the park. I know I collected the fries as well as the burger, but you know what? I'm gonna come back here anyway, so I might as well just complete that when the time comes. I can always get the fries back then, so whatever. What are you gonna do? But anyway, let's actually, we're not gonna go in the silo. Let's actually view our totals right now because, I have been neglecting that. I just wanna make sure I got everything in the world that I said I would. I believe I'm just one Cheeto page short, so, I'm actually gonna have to get that off screen so I won't bore you guys by doing that now and waste time, so. When I go back to Witchyworld down the road, I'll just get that Cheeto page. I probably could find it in my book easily. I just couldn't find this playthrough in the right spot. So anyway, yes, I think we'll have to end it here. Thank you guys for watching. Be sure to rate, comment, and subscribe. It helps my channel out immensely. And next part, we'll go into Jiggy's Temple and opening up the next world in the game. So I will see you later, guys. And until next time. Oh my God, it's a Triceratops!